In 2024, over 150 elections will happen worldwide. But did you know that computers run even more elections daily? Without this, our world will be slower and less reliable, from payment systems to your digital photos. Today we'll talk about legal election and consensus. This video is part of a distributed systems series tackling coordination challenges. Let's dig into it. Imagine we're building a photo sharing app. We want users to upload pictures and ensure they're always available. If we only have one database, its failure means losing everything. A backup helps, but involves downtime. Instead, we can use multiple databases for better traffic distribution and reliability. But how do we make sure they don't override each other and data is efficiently stored? In other words, how do we coordinate them? Enter leader election. Leader election is the process by which a group of processes or nodes in a distributed system select a single leader among them to coordinate and manage the system's activities. The leader is responsible for tasks such as resource allocation, task scheduling, and coordination of distributed algorithms. Leader election algorithms ensure that there's going to be always a single leader, even in the case of failure or network partitions. In the case of the picture example before, having one leader makes it easier to decide which process is going to write the data to all the nodes. But how do we pick a leader? Compared to human elections, there are less emotions involved in computers. Trust me, I've asked. There are several algorithms like Paxos and SAP, but today we're going to focus on RAFT, which is used in multiple systems like Kafka, etcd, and MongoDB. Picture a group of friends in a foggy place needing to elect a leader. In RAFT, everyone starts as a follower, called the follower state. If there's no leader, anyone can shout their name and term. For example, candidate Chris, first term. This is called the candidate state. If you hear someone else's name and term, you vote for them, indicating the name and term you heard. If a majority agrees, that person becomes the leader. If not, a new term starts. The leader keeps everyone updated with I'm okay signals called heartbeats. If this stops, a new election is triggered. All changes to the system are now done through the leader. It's not only important that the majority elects the leader, but that all the nodes agree to it. We need consensus. Consensus is the process by which a group of processes or nodes in a distributed system agree on a single value or decision despite the potential for failures or inconsistencies. Consensus is often used to ensure that all nodes in the system reach an agreement on critical decisions, such as committing a transaction, choosing a configuration option, or agreeing on a specific value. Consensus algorithms typically require processes to communicate, to propose and agree on values, while also ensuring properties like safety and liveness. The safety property of a system means that it guarantees certain bad things from happening, say, all nodes agree on the same value. And liveness is like good things will happen, say, eventually, all nodes agree on the value. Consensus is not only relevant for leader election, but also for data replication. In our picture sharing app, consensus ensures data replication is reliable. RAFT's main use case is data replication. It uses the concept of a state machine where all of the nodes start in the same state, and by applying the same operations in the same order, they all end up in the same state. Here's how the replication works step by step. Each node in the system has a log of operations and a state, which includes the actual data. When a client sends a request to store a file, the leader logs this entry in its own log first before actually changing the state. The leader then sends an append entries message to all follower nodes, which includes the new log entry. Each follower appends the received entry to its own log and sends an acknowledgement back to the leader. Once the leader receives acknowledgement from a majority of followers, it commits the entry. Committing means the entry is applied to the leader's state. For example, the file is saved. Then, the leader sends a message to the followers indicating the entry is committed. Followers then apply the entry to their own state. This process ensures that all the nodes maintain the same sequence of operations in their logs, leading to a consistent state across the system. Since we depend on the majority, several of the followers can fail and still work. In fact, if we have 2F plus 1 followers, F followers can fail. If the leader fails at any point, a new election is triggered. The new leader is chosen based on the highest log index, to ensure no data is lost. The new leader then continues to replicate entries from where the old leader left off. If a follower fails, the leader will send the append entries message indefinitely until it gets confirmation. In our app, using RAFT for distributed storage allows us to have one database as the leader, ensuring that when a photo is uploaded, it's replicated across all databases. This setup makes the app more robust and easier to scale, allowing it to serve reads from the replica nodes, for example, using the CQRS pattern that we saw in a previous video. Most of the time, you will need to implement RAFT, consensus, or leader election, as there are other systems that can handle it for you. Consensus and leader election can also be avoided by using coordination-free algorithms, for example. This is highlighted by the CAM theorem, but we won't cover it today. In practice, only electing a leader to perform one action can be solved more easily by getting a list or a log with a time to live, for example, using a key value store with atomic compare and swap operation. But it is still important to understand consensus and leader election, as they are used daily by many of the systems that keep our world running, including sharing pictures with our loved ones. Thanks for watching. Theory and practice go hand in hand in learning. If you want to practice some of the distributed system concepts that we have seen today, I recommend you Code Crafters. Code Crafters create advanced level programming challenges for software engineers. These are very complete and in-depth, and the content and approaches are reviewed by top talent. They have great hands-on tutorials like build your own Redis or build your HTTP server. You can also improve your programming language skills with one of the more than 15 trainings focused on language. I've partnered with them and you can get an exclusive 40% discount using this link. It's also in the description. Happy hacking!